It is now possible for patients to be able to easily obtain a copy of their CT sinus scan and view the images on their home computer. However, the images may be confusing without an explanation. But the good news is that CT sinus scans are actually easy to understand once you know what is going on, even for a patient without any medical background. In CT scans, there are basically three colors: black, white, and gray. Air is black, just like the black around the head. White is bone, just like any standard x-ray. Things that are gray denote fluid or soft tissues like the brain, eye, and tongue. When a CT sinus scan is performed, typically two different orientations are obtained. Axial, which is when we slice the head in the horizontal plane. Coronal, which would be as if we sliced the head like a loaf of bread in the vertical plane. The orientation that is most easily understood by a layperson is the coronal plane. Here is an animation showing the sinus anatomy in the coronal plane. Here is how it would look on a CT sinus scan in the coronal plane. The main slice that provides the most information in the coronal plane with respect to the sinuses is where one can see both eyeballs, brain, ethmoid sinuses, maxillary sinuses, and the tongue as shown here. You may have to scroll through the images until you find this particular image slice. You are in the correct slice when you can see both eyeballs located below the brain. Just like the black color around the head is air, normal sinus cavities should contain only a black color as well. If an active sinus infection is present, there would be a gray discoloration within the sinus cavities with either air bubbles as shown in the left maxillary sinus cavity, or an air fluid level as shown in the right maxillary sinus cavity here. If mucosal swelling suggestive of chronic sinus disease is present, there would be a more circumferential gray discoloration around the sinus cavities as shown here. If extensive nasal polyps are present, there may be very little black or air present in the sinus cavities. In this particular CT scan, there is extensive nasal polyps present in just the left sinus cavities with very little black or air seen. In another different patient's CT scan, nasal polyp disease is present on both sides. Not uncommonly, a small isolated mucosal inclusion cyst may be seen in the sinus cavity as shown here, which is considered to be of no significance. Should a patient suffer from sinus discomfort but the CT scan looks normal, then the patient does not have a sinus infection or any type of sinus pathology causing facial pain and pressure. Rather, symptoms may be due to some other problem which may include allergies, migraines, facial neuralgia, dental pathology, TMJ, etc.